Leader of the Official Opposition.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker, and I'm pleased and proud to rise following the comments by the member for Vancouver West End. It is Anti-Bullying Day, and I think an appropriate time and the first opportunity I've had to raise this issue with the Premier. She's been taken over the past number of months, Honorable Speaker, to have a, if you're not with me, you must be against me attitude towards British Columbians, most recently with respect to individuals, First Nations leaders in the North Coast area who are concerned about the sighting of a LNG facility on Leelu Island. They gathered together to express their concerns. They signed a declaration, and the response from the Premier was, quote, they were kind of a ragtag group of people. So let's ponder that for a moment, shall we? And keep in mind that the words of the member for Vancouver West End and all of the things that we have been doing as legislators, whether it's been on the front steps or in schools, as I have, and the member for Vancouver or Victoria Beacon Hill, words are powerful, words are harmful. And for the Premier of British Columbia to speak disrespectfully about a large group of people who have a different point of view, characterizing them as kind of a ragtag group of people, I think diminishes us all. So my question through you, Honourable Speaker, to the Premier is this. Does she believe that true reconciliation with First Nations begins with name calling?
Madam Premier.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I'm delighted the Leader of the Opposition is taking an interest in reconciliation. It has been a central part of what we've been trying to do, working toward in this government for many, many years now, and we are making very real progress with First Nations all across the province. Our goal has been to say, to make sure that if First Nations recognize that if First Nations have the economic means, then they can create their own vision, their own economy, in their own communities. Not a vision that's created by a government outside their community, not a vision that comes from Ottawa or Victoria, but a vision that they drive. And ultimately, that is what First Nations have been looking for over 150 years. Our government has been working tirelessly and in good faith with First Nations all across British Columbia to try and make sure we support them in finding the means, in creating the means for economic wealth. Because First Nations children and First Nations communities have been left out of the economic mainstream for far, far too long. We have a generational chance in this House to change that trajectory for First Nations. Opportunity, because First Nations have been waiting far, far too long. I am committed, members on this side of the House are committed, to making sure that First Nations get the chance, a crack at the economic mainstream, at a chance to be successful, at an opportunity for their children to get live in the kind of wealthy, healthy societies we all expect for our children, and we aren't going to stop until we get there.
Thank you, Premier. Leader of the Official Opposition on a supplemental.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. I suppose I can take some comfort in the Premier's comments, but when I look back at the track record of her and the BC Liberals, when the Nisga Treaty was ratified in this legislature, the BC Liberals voted against it. When they came to government, they not only tried to go to the Supreme Court and have the Nisga Treaty overturned, they then held, when the Premier was the Deputy Premier, a racist referendum on treaty rights. They put that question to the public, a minority rights put to the majority. Again, not necessarily the path to reconciliation. And then to call a group of individuals ragtag, they're obstacles to the Premier's vision. I mean, I heard what the Premier said, and I don't recall the Laxwell Lambs in their almost unanimous votes against this project saying, you know, if only we had this paternalistic vision from the Premier of British Columbia about liquefied natural gas, it would set us free. Quite the contrary, Honorable Speaker. Quite the contrary. The entire community said no. Yes, they did. Yes, they did, Honorable Speaker. So again,
through the chair, please.
The Premier went on beyond the comments about ragtag, and I think she sort of echoed those same comments today. She said in that media interview, quote, post-contact, those First Nations are going to have the first chance to create the kind of community that they want. Now, that may well be the premier's vision, but I think the best way to find out what those community wants, those communities want, is to ask them. And if you ask the Lac Seul Ams, if you ask the leadership that was at Leelu Island, you'd get a decidedly different answer than the one the premier wants to hear. So again, I pose the question through you, Honorable Speaker, to the premier. You blew up the treaty process in British Columbia, where we had had 25 years of hard work, and now you're calling those who disagree with you ragtag. Will the premier confirm today that if you're not with her, you must be against her, or is she going to rise above that and be the leader for all British Columbians, whether they agree with you or not?
Thank you, Madam Speaker.
The member forgets in his recitation of history that it has been this government that has signed all of the treaties that have come out of the treaty process, all of which have been a tremendous success for First Nations. We have signed hundreds of reconciliation and other kinds of agreements, economic agreements with First Nations over the last just few years, and every single one of those is a building block toward reconciliation. Most recently, we signed a landmark agreement with the Tsilhqot'in, which people said we could never achieve. We signed that agreement and for the first time heard sung a song that hasn't been heard and has been lost in that community, to that community, for over 75 years. In a moment that was moving for all of us. And so if the member wants to stand up and misconstrue history, he's certainly allowed to do that in this legislature. But the truth of it is, our government stands with First Nations. Our government stands up to make sure that First Nations get every opportunity, every generational opportunity that is being presented right now by saying yes to economic development projects, by saying yes to ensuring that First Nations are a part of those projects. And while that member will stand up and say no to those projects, when he does, he should remember, he is also saying no to those futures of First Nations people who have a chance at something they haven't had since contact with European people. And that's the chance to make their own future in an economic mainstream that they have been shut out of by European settlers for far, far too long.
Thank you, Premier. Leader of the Official Opposition on a supplemental.
Well, thank you, Honourable Speaker. And I'm trying to get my head around the Premier's comments about Grand Chief Stuart Phillip, ragtag, Chief Murray Smith, Chief Stan Dennis Sr., and Councillor Stan Dennis Jr. from Lac Seul Ams, ragtag. Chief John Risdale from the Wet'suwet'en, ragtag. Yvonne Laddie from the Gitxsan, ragtag. I'm wondering, Honourable Speaker, if although the Premier likes to say that everybody agrees with her when she stands in this place, surely she knows that that's not the case. Surely she has enough understanding of the complexities of British Columbia that she understands that there is a diversity of opinion on a whole range of issues. I'm prepared to accept that the Premier and I will rarely agree on anything. But I do not call her ragtag. I don't call her inappropriate. I allow her to have that opinion, and I express a counterpoint of view. Will the Premier, Honourable, today, through you, Honourable Speaker, will she take the opportunity to say to those individuals who she characterized as ragtag, will she respect their right to have a different point of view and maybe try and convince them through the powers of her considerable persuasion that maybe she can bring them on side rather than dismiss them as obstacles to her agenda, not theirs?
Madam Premier.
Thanks, Madam Speaker. I am pretty sure that the Leader of the Opposition has called me worse than ragtag in the past. Yeah. However, let's stick to the line of questioning that the members talked about. 36 First Nations have endorsed the project across British Columbia. We have Chief Harold Layton from the Metlakatla, Chief Clifford White from the Kitsala, Chief Dan Roberts from the Kitsum Kalem, Chief Joe Bevan from the Kitsalis, Councillor Chris Snanky on behalf of John Aline at the Lacs Quilam, Chief Arnold Clifton from the Gitgat First Nation, those First Nations in the region that have written a letter to his members asking them to stand down their opposition to this project, asking them to step aside, get out of the way, and let the First Nations in these communities decide their own future without the politics of no, without the politics of the NDP and the opposition. They want a chance to be able to make these decisions for themselves. They wrote that letter asking these members to step down, to step and take a step back and allow them to make these decisions, and those members from the New Democrats refused. And I wish there had been First Nations in the gallery today. We know that there are pipe fitters and members of other unions who are with us in the precincts today. Those are the people in British Columbia that we stand with when we work to get to yes on economic development projects. Those are the people who will benefit when those projects go ahead. Everyone in this province has the right to freedom of speech, and there won't be a single project where we agree. But the thing that fundamentally differentiates the government from the NDP opposition is this. While they look for every way to try and say no to growth, when they look for every way to say no to jobs, on this side of the House, we stand on the side of trying to find every way that we can to build consensus so that we can get to yes.